Hello, Theodore Giras here, guitarcourses.org, and another brand new free lesson for you. Today I'm gonna show you a cool trick how to play a diminished arpeggio over a major chord. It doesn't make sense? I will make it make sense to your ears. So let's go straight to the pattern and the theoretical analysis behind this thing. So first of all, I will put my computer a E major chord. Just have in mind that I'm a whole step down tuned, so I am in standard D. So it's D, G, C, etc. So I'm gonna put now a E major happy chord, groovy, and in purpose I prefer to use something funky. You will understand later why I'm doing that. So, E major chord. So this is the E major chord. And I have a root, major third G sharp, and a root and perfect fifth B. So it's root, major third, and perfect fifth. Now what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna add one more degree. I'm gonna add the seventh, and I'm gonna use a dominant seventh. So instead of only playing three notes, I'm gonna add one more note, and over the D major, E major chord, I'm gonna play a E7 arpeggio. Can I do it? Of course I can. Root, major third, perfect fifth, minor seventh, root, so on. So have a E dominant seventh arpeggio, and I'm playing over a E major chord. So now let's go to the next level. I must play a scale over this major chord and the dominant 7th arpeggio. My first and obvious choice is to play a Mixolydian mode, because I have the major 3rd and the dominant 7th. So I'm gonna do now the E Mixolydian over the E major chord. One more time. Root, major second, major third, perfect fourth, perfect fifth, major sixth, minor seventh, and root. A small piece of improvisation to listen to the mode. So I have an E major chord, and I'm playing over it an E Mixolydian, and my arpeggio is E dominant 7th. And now the fun begins. What I'm gonna do? On the E major, or on the E dominant arpeggio, I'm gonna take out the root. The root is E. So my remaining notes are the G sharp, the B, and the D. And now we have a brand new chord, and I'm gonna analyze it for you. I have a G sharp as a root, one. I have a minor third, the B, because I have 1.5 tone between those two notes. And then I have a diminished fifth. So I have 1, flat 3, flat 5. So what is it? This is a diminished G sharp, diminished 3 voice chord. That's it. Pretty easy. Now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna put one more degree on the G sharp diminished, and I'm going to transform it into D sharp diminished seventh. So I have. This sounds really spooky and scary. And I have only minor thirds. One, flat three, minor third. Flat three, flat five. So also it's also minor third. And then from a flat five to the double flat seven, I have a also one more minor third. So I have symmetrical minor thirds up. So I have an E major chord, which sounds really happy and dancing and grooving, but I have something that is really spooky, it's really scary. Let's see how it sounds, the G sharp diminished arpeggio over the E major chord. Let's give it a try. I'm gonna start with the Amix Olivian. And now I'm gonna play a G sharp diminished. Let's see. It sounds great. I'm gonna do a small improvisation, something easy. So I have the G sharp diminished arpeggio over the E major chord. It sounds great, and to be honest, we didn't did something really, you know, something really important. I'm just using some basic theory rules, and I'm trying to be creative. This approach is really simple, and we can use it in any kind of music. We can use it in jazz. We can use it in rock, in metal, in Greek folk music. It's pretty common, this approach to play a diminished arpeggio over a major chord. Even Yngwie is doing that. Yngwie uses a E major chord, and he plays the E Phrygian dominant, and a G sharp diminished. Over the E major. So Yngwie use the same rule, the same approach. So this was the lesson for today. It's a cool way in order to play something different over something obvious in order to make it sound really cool and really interesting. I am trying to analyze with you and to make it as simple as I can. So I hope that you can enjoy this lesson. So it was Theodore Ziras, it was guitarcourses.org. If you like the video, you can go thumbs up and share it to your friends. Also, if you want to download the backing track and the charts and the tabs and the backing tracks about this lesson, I have a Patreon page that you can join. The link is here, and you can support my channel. I will see you next time. Until then, bye bye.